Recorded Books presents Treasure Tracks by S.A. Rodriguez. Narrated by Giordan Diaz. Chapter 1. A Pirate's Soul. Submerged in the deep blue ocean, the world stood still all around me. I'm talking too still, with fish and all the wonders of the sea in hiding mode. Only seagrass and sand. Boring. My first official cred secured scuba dive and I'd discovered a big ol' nothing. Goose egg. 0 on the adventure scale. Abuelo Kiki made frantic hand gestures beside me. Up, up, up. A glance at the gauge confirmed my air would end soon. I propelled myself from the sandy bottom. Off like a rocket. Swoosh! Bubbles trailed behind. Within seconds, my face broke above the final wall of clear blue water, bathwater warm in the heat. The sky greeted us, but the early September sun was not smiling down. Dark gray clouds warned of trouble. Abuelo surfaced next to me.
No time to lose, Finn. Weather's about to turn. Some of the outer bands of the storm seem to be making their way in. Gotta shove on. Highway's gonna be crammed. Everyone fighting to get out. And I promised to get you home to Miami before it hit.
Wish we could stay and hang in the Keys, I grumbled.
According to the weather radio this morning, Hurricane Irma's about 100 miles south of here, ravaging Cuba. She'll travel up the Florida Straits and hit us sometime tomorrow morning.
I yanked off my mask and regulator. The challenge was balancing the heavy tank on my back. The duck-like fins on my feet didn't make it any easier. Waddle, waddle. My knees buckled in awkward angles, climbing the ladder on the stern of the boat. Abuelo plopped onto the deck behind me, his chest rising up and down in labored movements. He struggled to tear off gear. Gone was the rock-hard strength that used to pulse through his tanned arms. His faded anchor tattoos sagged where impressive lumps used to bulge on his biceps. How could this be? He was so much tougher than me. Pass me your tank, I extended a hand.
I can manage on my own, Abuelo snapped. Get busy. Pull down the dive flag and bring up the anchor.
He gestured to the bow of his vintage 1973 19-foot Boston Whaler.
Don't know how I let you talk me into going out today.
Birthday gift, I reminded him, before crawling along the rails, real grateful to have my sea legs back and loose the clumsy web feet. I pulled on the line stretched out from a cleat on the bow but couldn't get the anchor to budge. Not one bit. From the stern, Abuelo grunted in his usual drill sergeant way.
Come on, boy. Give it some muscle.
My palms stung as I struggled to keep a grip on the wet line. I braced myself and pulled, inch by inch. No chance I'd let Abuelo down even if my pitiful pecs were still in training. Besides, one day soon, I'd help him haul up something way better than this stupid dead weight.
Ah!
I finally lugged the anchor on board and waved an imaginary pirate hook in the air. Not letting anyone mess with our treasure.
Little to worry about, Abuelo scoffed. No one knows it exists.
But there's hundreds of divers coming out to the Florida Keys. As if on cue, a boat motored into view with a Conquer Scuba logo painted on its side. The big C at the front curved into a sea serpent tail slithering under the rest of the letters.
See what I mean? Invading.
That there's a dive master. One of the pros, paid to be out unlike me. The driver saluted before racing out of sight. You think he's after our loot? Only other boat we've seen since we anchored here.
Different kinds, Abuelo chuckled. Treasure comes in many forms. Natural ones hidden all over our coral reefs.
I want the real stuff.
Sure you do. Couldn't wait a day past your 12th birthday to go hunting, aye, matey? He winked.
Over the summer, he had paid for my scuba lessons and given me equipment. I'd just finished the course and was now officially a junior open water scuba diver. I knew the lessons and my equipment had cost him a lot, but he never grumbled about it. I raised two thumbs in the air. Been waiting to get certified for a long time. Like my whole life long, or at least since the first time I remember dipping my toes in the ocean. A school of minnows came to greet me. We played hide and seek, but Mommy had to grab me when I tried to follow them into the deep. Abuelo's expression turned serious, pulling me out of memory mode.
You got no business having me as your dive buddy. I'm getting too old for this.
Old? I snorted, You act younger than Dad. Way, way younger. Where's your sense of adventure? It's what you always tell him.
Abuelo took my bait. Listen, Squirt. Back in my day, I could teach you a thing or two about diving and adventure.
He shook his finger, and his voice dropped to a whisper.
But your dad will have my head mounted on a wall like my sailfish if he gets wind of what we're up to. Too risky as far as he'd be concerned, especially with the storm on the way.
Relax. You always say I practically have gills. It'll be our secret. I drew a finger to my lips, as usual.
I know all too well about them gills of yours. You got salt water flowing through your veins. How you think you landed your nickname Finn?
I rolled my eyes, even though I was totally grateful for the nickname he'd given me. Finn was way cooler than the uber Latino name my parents, or actually mommy, gave me. Fernando. If I closed my eyes, I could hear mommy belting out Lady Gaga's song, Alejandro. Mommy's version was heavy on the Spanish accent, and super exaggerated rolling of the R's. Especially the part where she'd scream out my name when the refrain switched to, Fernando. Made my skin crawl. Abuelo interrupted my thoughts.
You were 2 years old. Even then you used to jump and swim out from my dock. No one could stop you. Used to scare the bejesus out of your dad. Think you learned to swim before you could walk. Born with fins, I always said.
I gave him my best cheeky grin. Yep, meant to be diving. Besides, only 40 feet deep here. Not risky at all. We didn't even have to stop and decompress. How much trouble could we possibly get into? Boom. The distant cannon of a thunderbolt fired off a warning.
Get into position, Abuelo commanded.
I hustled back to sit next to him in the captain's chair, which was big enough for both of us. He rummaged through his duffel bag and pulled out his favorite Panama hat. Pressing the straw covering over his head, he added shade to a splattering of sunspots.
Let's go batten down the hatches. Hit the road.
He revved the 150 horses of his Evinrude outboard to life, shouting over the noise.
Not much time left, and this Irma gal's a mean one. She'll be packing quite a punch coming in as a Cat 4.
I gripped the handrail that went around the console. The boat slammed up and down, pounding over the waves, and swayed from side to side. Water splashed onto the deck, slapping sea salt over every inch of my skin, dampening my courage. Gulp. You really think Irma's going to be as bad as they say? I shouted. Abuelo frowned.
Who knows? But we haven't had a real monster hit the quay since the Labor Day hurricane of 1935. Storm of the century, they called it.
Were you there? For the storm of the century?
Hey, Abuelo jabbed lightly on my shoulder. I'm getting old, but not that old.
Right, duh. I did the math in my head. He'd have to be ancient, more than 90, to remember that storm.
Almost wiped out the quays, swept away our railroad.
A crackle of lightning hit the water near the port side of the boat.
As more thunder boomed, Abuelo studied the sky again. Hold tight.
He put the engine into full throttle and strengthened his grip on the wheel. I sank deeper into the seat cushions.
Too bad it's gone. Not just lost, it went poof.
He snapped his fingers.
Swallowed up by the sea. Tidal wave hit the train, he bellowed. Flung all the rail cars on their sides like toys.
A strong gust of wind whisked away his hat, but he didn't bother glancing over the stern, where it disappeared in our churning wake, far beyond reach. Me? I leaned into him in the captain's chair, holding on till my knuckles turned white. Long minutes elapsed until we approached shore, passing a slow no-wake marker as Abuelo pulled way back on the throttle.
The treasure, Abuelo said. It was on board.
What? You never told me about the train before, only that you knew the way to a lost treasure. This is a way cooler story.
Abuelo's nod turned somber. He stared over the horizon. About time I tell you the truth. Don't think anyone else knows.
Only me? This was a big deal. He chose to trust me. How do you know? I pressed on. One thing was sure. Abuelo's life was part mystery. He ignored my question.
I won't be around forever. This'll be your secret to keep.
You know I'm a good keeper of secrets. We're co-conspirators, you always tell me. I tried my best to wink, though it probably looked more like an eye spasm as I did the one-eyed blinky blink. Abuelo smiled.
At least I got one trooper left in the family.
Yep, that's me, Team Abuelo and Finn. Get to the good stuff, I urged, rubbing my sore hands together. Do you know what's hidden in the chest? Abuelo fell silent, his eyes trained over the ocean as we sliced through angry swells. Don't stop, I pleaded. The wind responded with a high-pitched howl and a punch to the side of the hull. Abuelo started up again.
Never said it was buried in a chest. This isn't pirate treasure like in some bedtime story. He chuckled. It's real. Old Spanish gold brought in from Cuba. Who knows where it came from? Probably an old shipwreck. Must be worth millions today.
Millions? This was far more than I ever imagined. It comes from the same place we do?
Yes, your home country, at least from my side. You got your mom's Puerto Rican blood mixed in too. Frijoles con habichuelas, he snickered. Mix of Caribbean beans.
Forget the beans. Images of glowing doubloons floated through my mind. So if it's gold, it kind of is like pirate treasure. They always had those old coins stashed in chests. Abuelo shook his head as he turned into the narrow canal leading to his home. As we approached, he cut the motor, letting the boat drift up to his dock. The second it bumped against the edge, I jumped onto the wooden planks to complete my first mate duties. I knotted a thick blue line to a metal cleat the way he'd taught me and I'd perfected.
Grab a bumper, he pointed,
then started attaching more lines to the boat and throwing them to me.
Gotta tie up real good before we scoot out of here. Make sure Sirena makes it. Canal should protect her from the bigger swells.
My mind was on other things as I secured the rubber fender toward the stern. We'll find it. I know we can.
I've tried for many years, you know. It's a treasure that doesn't want to be found. Still lies in a watery grave.
A shiver went up my spine. You think when we find it, there'll be creepy pirate skeletons watching over it?
You've got Captain Jack Sparrow on the brain, Finn. But lots of piracy in the Caribbean, to be sure. There weren't the glorified adventurers you see in movies, though. Cuba built these huge fortresses to defend itself. Keep him out.
Wish we could visit Cuba together. I'd love a chance to visit the place in person after all these years of listening to his stories. He'd taken me to Little Havana in Miami, named after the capital of Cuba, where we'd played dominoes in a park, but that couldn't possibly be the same thing.
One day when it's free. Not giving a dime to those dictators.
Abuelo's voice trembled with anger till it shook up a fit of coughing. Right. Useless try. Best not to get Abuelo started. I had his Cuban rants practically memorized. Besides, I liked my American freedoms just so. We'll be so rich when we find it, we can go anywhere.
Careful, Finn. Treasure can turn men into real pirates, Abuelo mumbled.
Another bolt of lightning shot down from the heavens to match the warning in his tone. In spite of the heat and humidity, a chill crept all the way down to my bones. Chapter 2. Twisted Reality. Less than an hour later, I plopped into the cab of Abuelo's pickup. We rolled up the overseas highway, the famous interstate cutting through the sea, with bridge after bridge connecting the long string of small islands known as keys. It was supposed to deliver the sweeping water views printed on countless postcards that said, "Greetings from the Florida Keys. Wish you were here." Except now, the highway offered the exact opposite of a welcome. Waves threatened to drown out the road as the surf crept its way in. And for sure, Abuelo's truck wouldn't be able to swim nearly as well as me. Even the palm trees warned things were anything but the usual serene. Their leaves made an angry dance in the heavy breeze. Inches ahead, an 18-wheeler rattled to a dead stop, blasting out a cloud of black smoke that drifted back through our windows, filling my lungs. Cough, cough.
Crapola, Abuelo muttered. I was hoping to beat the rush. Parking lot out here now. At this rate, we won't reach Miami till nightfall. And this toxic.
Ding, ding, ding. My phone had been working fine yesterday when Abuelo and I left the mainland and came down to his place. But there'd been no service all morning. Until now. Maybe something to do with the storm.
You're gonna answer those beeps? I'm getting ready to throw that darn phone of yours out the window.
Not sure why you young people even bother with those things.
All this technology stuff telling you what to do. Always on, always intruding. My phone now displayed 5 missed calls and 8 messages. Mommy, 8:03 a.m. Happy birthday, see you soon. Smiling emoji. Mommy, 12:17 p.m. Where are you? Supposed to be home hours ago. Mommy, 1:30 p.m. Call me. Mommy, 2:40 p.m. Call me, now. Mommy, 3:22 p.m. You better call me right now. Dad, 3:35 p.m. Report home. We're worried. Mommy, 3:47 p.m. Hurricane is hitting soon. Are you okay? Mommy, 3:52 p.m. We'll call police to search for you. I took a deep breath, cough, cough, before pressing the phone symbol in her contact. Good thing she couldn't ring my neck over the airwaves. Mommy answered on the first ring. Fernando Javier Cordero Román. Where have you been? She yelled. Ouch. If she was torturing me with my full-on Latino name, all 4 ridiculous parts of it, she had to be a 10 out of 10 on the anger scale. I pulled the cell farther from my ear. What's up? Why are you texting like 100 times? I'm okay. What is up? Really? Why didn't you call sooner? I got you the phone so we could keep tabs on you. My phone hasn't been getting service until just now. I swear. We're driving back now. Promise. Traffic's bad. Oh, okay. And happy birthday, mi amor. Bitter melted to sugar sweet in mommy's still too loud voice. When will you be home? I glanced at Abuelo.
Could be hours, he said with a shrug.
No clue, mommy. Did I hear Enrique say hours? Hours? Por Dios!
Her cry turned to silence, a standard extra helping of mom guilt. What did I even do? I stared at the phone. She hung up.
That didn't go so well, Abuelo said with a smirk.
Sure, I'll get an earful too. Promise I'd get you back way before the storm hit, and we might be losing the race.
He popped his head out the driver's window to stare at the dark sky. You mean the hurricane's going to hit us in your truck? I tried to stay calm, but a wall of angry black clouds choked out the light, strangling my cool.
Nah.
As the music station we were listening to cut to commercials, Abuelo messed around with the dial. He stopped when he reached a news channel. We sat in silence for the next few minutes listening to the weatherman go on and on. A never-ending list of predictions and warnings that all said the same thing. Alert! Alert! Run for your lives!
Not sure how I'm going to make it back to the Keys tonight before they shut it down.
Abuelo grumbled before switching over to a music station.
What do you mean? You're not staying with us? The weather dude said the Keys could get wiped away with the tidal surge.
Nothing's going to wash away this old man.
Old.
I turned to look at him as he peered out the windshield. Deep wrinkles were set at the corners of Abuelo's eyes, and for the first time, I noticed his thin gray hair had turned a silvery shade of white. When did that happen?
Rather keep Sirena company. Make sure my girl doesn't sink. Don't need another treasure swallowed up by the sea. Besides, you know your dad and I don't do well in the same room for too long.
But, you can't.
I pouted. Could it be he loved his boat more than his favorite grandson? His only grandson? Me? His sirena shouldn't be reason enough to stay. I grasped at a way to keep him with me. You could get washed out like the railroad did.
Save it, boy. Times were different back then. My house is solid concrete on stilts. Even has those shutters we bolted on at the crack of dawn.
What if something happened to you?
The important thing is I get you home safe. You got your whole life ahead of you. I've already had my share of adventures.
My heart skipped a beat. Don't talk like that. You freak me out when you do.
Abuelo smiled, but terrible thoughts invaded my head. I couldn't get past the image of the train getting swept over by the sea. Do you have any idea where the treasure went? Is it where we dove today?
Happened so long ago. Currents could have taken it anywhere. Buried it deep. Could be miles and miles out to sea from where the train went off the tracks. We're looking for a needle in an endless ocean haystack.
You mean you don't have actual coordinates? GPS stuff? I always thought you had a hidden treasure map with spots to check out.
Nope. Educated guesses are better than tech any day. Been studying these waters for years.
Abuelo chuckled.
But did you know that this highway follows some of the exact same path where the railroad tracks used to be?
No way, I said, as I looked out at the churning surf. My worries about getting swept away by the stormy sea only got worse.
Pop, pop, pop. Tiny ice bullets sounded off like party poppers slamming against the driveway on a 4th of July. They pelted the roof and windshield with pint-sized fury. I stared out the window and couldn't believe what I saw.
What?
What?
What's that?
My finger shook, pointing to a thin funnel dropping down from a cloud. It sucked up water with every rotation twirling its way over the ocean. Toward us.
Is that part of the hurricane?
Tornado? Images of Abuelo's truck getting scooped up and spit out in an imaginary Ozland terrorized my thoughts. Instead of the Wicked Witch of the West, I'd end up in the lost kingdom of Atlantis face to face with a giant man-eating squid. I'd hated squids ever since dissecting one in science class. I closed my eyes as I imagined his evil tentacles bedazzled in red rubies lunging at me.
Ah!
Why'd I even watch all those crazy movies? I slapped myself straight across the face.
Stop!
Tranquilo, Finn.
Abuelo put his hand over mine.
It's only a small water spout. They hardly ever make their way inland. We get them all the time. No big deal.
Yeah, right. No big deal.
More water spouts in the Keys than anywhere in the world.
That's supposed to make me feel better? I sucked in my breath and put on my bravest face. It's what Abuelo would expect. Fearless Finn, fearless Finn, I chanted under my breath, summoning the courage of the 2-year-old version of me he had described. No use, only swimming in the ocean made me fearless. We were suspended above it, high as a skyscraper, on the tippy-top hump of a bridge.
Will we get blown off if it hits us? We're not exactly inland.
Nah, stop worrying.
But we're stuck up here, like, not moving. And your truck's rocking back and forth.
A little rain and wind, lots worse than this to come. Look.
Abuelo pointed.
Traffic's starting to move. We'll roll off in no time, and spout's almost gone. They don't last long.
At least that part was true. Only a thin line shooting down from the wall cloud remained while we inched our way forward. Just when I was feeling a little safer, he said.
Keep your eyes peeled for crocodiles now.
Abuelo waggled his eyebrows and pointed to a crocodile crossing sign on the side of the road.
Long stretch of Everglades to go before we hit the concrete jungle.
Very funny. I'm sure they're all hiding. Even the fish were out of sight when we dove.
Birds are gone too. Animals sense the big storms way before our sophisticated instruments do.
Blaring sirens and a loud buzzing sound shut out all other noise. A line of police cars raced south on the opposite side of the highway. A helicopter followed the convoy, keeping close to the ground, away from the clouds and near the action. I could make out a news station logo at the same time a man leaned through the open door. He balanced a video camera in his arms and jerked it in our direction. We were part of the news.
Hey!
I stuck my head out the truck window and made the radical sign with both hands.
What's with all the cops?
I turned to Abuelo. A flush of frustration crept across his face.
Looks like they're doing a final sweep. I guess they are closing off all the highway going into the Keys. You can get out, but you can't go back in. Better if it were more like this Hotel California tune.
Abuelo cranked up the radio.
You can check out any time you like, but you can never leave.
He sang along.
Much better never leaving the island side.
I ignored his grumbling and fist-pumped the air. Sorry to make you ditch the Keys for me, but it means you get to check in at my house.
And never leave.
Hee hee. You can't go back tonight.
Great. Abuelo snorted.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.